Internet is the place where people exchange ideas, set up businesses, find jobs, find the information they are looking for, and sometimes people even find the love of their life on the internet. But the internet is much more than that. It can also be an engine for social change. It holds governments accountable, and in Egypt we have seen that it can even topple dictators. As liberals, we cherish the open internet. But unfortunately, not everybody agrees with us. From across the Atlantic, we see governments looking over our shoulders and storing our data as we surf. In Turkey, we are seeing attempts to block YouTube, Facebook, Google. In a lot of countries, the open internet is under attack. Well, let's make sure that this will never happen in Europe. My group, the European Liberals and Democrats, has voted against ACTA. Our vote was decisive, and I'm proud of this because this treaty could have hurt our online fundamental rights and freedoms. Furthermore, we have proposed legislation to strengthen the net neutrality. And with these proposals, we make sure that data is treated equally regardless of the source, and that all citizens and businesses have easy and equal access. This is progress, but there is still a lot of work to be done. Therefore, I'm happy with the proposals and ideas you have put forward in your WePromise.eu campaign. I support your ideas. If I become president of the European Commission, the digital agenda becomes a key priority. Firstly, by introducing European Wi-Fi and turn all our municipal wireless networks into wireless access zones. Secondly, I want to shift the focus in the European budget from agriculture to digital. In the current budget, Europe will spend nearly 300 billion euro on the common agriculture policy, but only 1 billion on high-speed internet. Let's start to spend a smaller percentage on COES and start to invest in high-speed broadband, in digital training and education. And thirdly, if we create a joint financial vehicle between European Investment Bank and European Commission, we can provide cheap credits for innovative startups. Europe needs these startups. They create jobs, they create economic growth. Last but not least, we should create an environment in which privacy and competitiveness go hand in hand. I don't believe privacy should be seen as a restriction to innovation. Smart privacy regulation can and should be an incentive to develop new applications and new technologies. Therefore, as Commission President, I will defend the right to be forgotten and privacy by default. Let's make sure that the internet remains ours.